श्री महागणाधिपतये नमः। ओम श्री महासरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम। ओम शरदिन्दुसमाकारे परब्रह्मस्वरूपिणि वासरापीठनिलये सरस्वति नमोऽस्तुते। ओम गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। Now Sri Venkatagaru will start.
So we are doing 27th shloka. We did 26 last week. 27th. Okay. We'll go with the pronunciation. Manya Guru Vinitasya Lakshmanasya Guru Priya Yadi Sita Api Dukkharta कालोहि दुरतिक्रमः। मान्या गुरुविनीतस्य लक्ष्मणस्य गुरुप्रिया
लक्ष्मणस्य गुरुप्रिया
यदि सीतापि दुःखार्ता
यदि सीतापि दुःखार्ता
कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः
कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः।
टु पदम्स् टुगेदर्। मान्या गुरुविनीतस्य लक्ष्मणस्य गुरुप्रिया यदि सीतापि दुःख कार्ता कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः
यदि सीतापि दुःखार्ता कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः यदि सीतापि दुःखार्ता कालो हि दुरतिक्रमः।
ओके, नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट गुरु गार टू एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग।
दिस श्लोक He is having a very, very famous quotation. That quotation is Kalohi Duratikramaha. That is, time is beyond our reach, beyond our access sometimes. It is all powerful. Time is all powerful. It is a very, very famous quotation. You should get by heart at least this quotation. When do we use this quotation? Normally, when a problem is there in our surroundings, we take all precautions. Even when you have taken all precautions, still the problem is knocking our doors, then it means that the problem is more powerful than our efforts. We are going to succumb to the problems. Then ultimately say, no, time is like that. We have to accept it. Because actually there is one important thing is there in Ramayana. On what basis the things happen? On what happen? On what? Based on what the things happen? Is it the things happen based on the intelligence of the person? Or his commandership? This is all physical efforts, what we think. Or is it that the thing is going to happen as per the horoscope? Suppose it is already recorded in our horoscope that such and such a thing is going to happen. Then the things will be happening. Then your efforts have no meaning. Is it like that? Or there is another way. Suppose a guru is there. If a guru declares, yes, you will be happy. even if we have all thousands of problems, we will be happy. That is the grace of God, grace of Guru. So if the Guru curses, even if somebody is very happy, he will become unhappy. Or if the God himself declares, no, this problem should not touch this person, even if that person is going to have that problem, God has declared that he will not have the problem will disappear. So ultimately, based on what the things are happening, this shloka touches some of those points. If a person is very intelligent, very pious, he never did any mistake, never committed any sin in his lifetime, then the problem should not come. That what actually is indicated by the first word, manya, highly respected lady. Who is that? Sita Devi. Yadi Sita Api. That word Sita is there. Sita, that is Sita Devi, is highly respected, highly pious. She never committed even a single error in her lifetime. Single sin she never committed. But still the problem has come. More than that, she is guarded by one more person. That is Lakshmana. When she is under the guardship of Lakshmana, then the problem should not touch at all. Because Lakshmana is not an ordinary person. Here, please understand, Lakshmana is the Ansha of Adishesha, the great serpent. Adishesha means Sri Mahavishnu Padukkununtadu. Lord Vishnu sleeps or takes his rest on the great serpent Adishesha. But what actually Adishesha represents? Adishesha, there are two words, please understand. Adi and Shesha. Adi means beginning. Shesha means the remainder. What actually he means, Adishesha represents in one way that time. Because before the Srishti started, the time started tickling. And then everybody disappears. Entire whole universe is dissolved. Laya has happened. Even then the time will be existing. So time is in the beginning and time is at the end. That actually is indicated by the two words Adi and Shesha. And Lakshmana is an incarnation of Adi Shesha. That is, he himself is the incarnation of time. Now, what type of person Lakshmana is? He is Guru Vinitasya, the most obedient to his gurus, most obedient to his teachers, most obedient to all the sages, most obedient to, more than all, to Lord Rama himself. Lakshmana himself declares that Sri Rama is my guru. He declares to Hanuman. When actually they met the first time, then he says, Lord Rama is my guru. So Guru Vinitasya, that Guru Shabda stands not only for his teachers, not only for the sages, almost to the God also. So he himself never committed any mistake. He himself never committed any sin. Then the problem should not come at all. And somebody is under his care. The persons who are under his care will never have, should never have the problems. And then, what type of relationship actually Lakshmana is having towards Sita Devi? She is Guru Priya. She is consort of his guru. So if he is respectful to his guru, and if that lady is the wife of that great person, then Lakshmana will be taking more care. Even then also, she should not have any problem. But problem has touched her. She is under midst of the problems. What can be the reason? Guru himself is pleased to protect anybody. And the person actually serving the guru himself is most obedient servant. And more than all, he is the incarnation of time itself. But still she is having the problems. Then what can we say? That is, the time itself is bound by the time. Kalo hi durati kramaha. Even Lakshmana also doesn't want to come out of that time cycle. That is, nobody can stop this, the effects of time. That actually great impact of this. Normally, you know, we should make all our efforts to solve our problems. If we are not able to solve our problems, we should approach great gurus. We should follow their guidelines. We should make some parayana. We should make some prayers. We should make some yagas. We should go to some tirthayatras. Even then, if the problems come, that is because of the earlier births, what we may have done, some sins that nobody can stop, that we have to undergo that process. So, kalo hi dorati kramaha. Then what happens is, you just abide by the time. The problem comes, that will be the problem will be for some time, and the time will be continuously running. So the problem automatically gets solved. But you have to wait for that much time. But that period is very, very harsh to adjust ourselves. But we have to bear, that's all. This actually, that is, if we have selected this problem, this shloka for our children is, in our lifetimes, we may have certain problems. We may not be direct reasons for that problem. We may not be direct. The problem has not occurred because of our sins. Because of it has not come because of our negligence. But in such a that type of situations also may arise. Then what we should do? We should not slip into depression. Let us bear it. Let us undergo the trouble. Automatically the problem will be solved. As the time goes on, you will have this solution. This your that courage within the time itself is there that we should follow it. So the selection for this shloka is based on that. Kalo hi dorati kraham, most important quotation. And this is used in Mahabharata several times. This is used in Bhagavata several times. Okay? Nice, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. It's very relevant now. So because of the current times,
yes.
So we can just need to have a lot of patience to come out of the current situation.
Now in the corona period, you see, we are sitting in our own house. Now actually the second wave that has started, it has entered into almost everybody's house, it's coming. We have not gone out. But even then, we may purchase something, some fruits, we may purchase some vegetables. Somehow we are getting it. Somebody recently, just 2 days back, one of my friends, he has gone for eye surgery. He went for eye surgery, but he came back with corona and he expired. He expired just 2 days back. How can we stop it? Then ultimately we have to reconcile. Kalo hi dorati krama. That time is such a powerful thing. Let us accept it. But the problem will be solved within by the time itself. That confidence also that I have it. Okay, sir. Thank you.
I will chant the whole shloka. Okay. Manya guru vinitasya lakshmanasya guru priya yadi sita pi dukkarta kalo hi durati krama.
Manya guru vinitasya lakshmanasya guru priya yadi sita pi dukkarta kalo hi durati krama. Manya guru vinitasya lakshmanasya guru priya yadi sita pi dukkarta kalo hi durati krama.
We will go to the next shloka. So the relation between Dampati, Bharya Bharta relation, husband and wife. So how precious, how glorious. Bharta Nama Param Narya Bhushanam Bhushanadapi Eshatu Rahita Tena Bhushanarha na shobhate. Bharta nama param narya bhushanam bhushanadapi eshatu rahita tena bhushanarha na shobhate.
Ikkada narya cheppevudu naryaha ani aapandi adike
naryaha. Bharta nama param naryaha.
Bharta nama param narya bhushanam bhushanadapi
esha tu rahita tena
तुरहिता
भूषणार्हा न शोभते।
भूषणार्हा
भर्ता नाम परं नार्या भूषणं भूषणादपि।
भर्ता नाम परं नार्या भूषणं भूषणादपि
एषा तु रहिता तेन भूषणार्हा न शोभते।
एषा तु रहिता तेन भूषणार्हा न शोभते एषा तु रहिता तेन भूषणार्हा न शोभते
Now, this shloka reflects the India's great value system. Our whole Sanatana Dharma is based on the Grihastha Ashrama. Our Hindu religion is originally called as Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana means eternal, not ancient. Sanatana means eternal dharma. Now that principle, the Sanatana Dharma has got several subsects. Several aspects are there. Within that, there are four ashramas: Brahmacharya Ashrama, Grihastha Ashrama, Vanaprastha Ashrama, and Sannyasa Ashrama. Among these four, the wife and husband, that relationship will be occurring only in the third one, mainly, partially in the Vanaprastha also. All the other three, Brahmacharya, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasa, they are dependent on the Grihasthas, the families. How here the family system, which is directly related, and it is based on the relationship between the wife and husband in our Sanatana Dharma. There actually, we have several stories in our Sanatana Dharma reflecting the Pativracha, the holy relationship between the wife and husband. There, particularly the ladies, they treat their husbands with highest respect, with highest piousness. And sometimes, you know, they will be able to stop the whole universe if any problem is coming to the husband, to their husbands. In such a situation. So, how actually you can depict the relationship between the wife and husband? Here it says, Bharta nama param nari. Here actually, you know, the visargas, nariyaha. That if you stop here, you have to spell as, you have to pronounce as nariyaha. In a single breath, if you are reading out, nariyaha bhoshanam bhoshanam. Bharta nama param nariyaha bhoshanam bhoshanadati. But if you are giving a small pause, Bharta nama param nariyaha, you have to say. Now here, the husband in our Sanatana Dharma, he is one of the best jewel, one of the best jewels to her. She may have several ornaments. She may have rings. She may have garlands. She may have even crowns also. Several varieties of alankaras may be there. Ornaments can be there. But there is one more ornament for her, which cannot be seen directly as an ornament, but it is more than all the ornaments. What is that? The husband. The husband for a lady is the best of the best ornaments. Bhoshanam bhoshanadapi. She is an ornament to the ornaments itself. So that is the way the husband was respected. Why actually Sita Devi has come to forest? She could have stayed in the palace at Ayodhya, or she could have gone to her father's house, Janaka's Mithila. No, she came to forest because she thought, when my husband is going to forest, how can I enjoy staying back in Ayodhya or Janaka's Mithila Nagara. Particularly in the palaces, no, I cannot enjoy. If he is suffering, I should also suffer. If he is eating, I should eat. If he is fasting, I should also fast. I am part of his body and he is more than everything for me. I should have all the feelings. I should be able to protect. Actually, she says, before starting from Ayodhya, she says, Muradhananti agratasthe gamishyami Muradhananti kushakantakam. Hey Rama, you are not allowing me immediately to come to follow you. But I am saying, I will be walking before you. Not that I will be following you physically. Not that you should go first. Then afterwards, as a second person, I should be coming behind you. No, I should go first. I should put first. Then, if there are any thorns are there, they should hit my foot first of all. Then I will be removing the thorns on the way. Then you can put your foot. Muradhananti, kusha, our holy grasses, their kushas, they're very sharp. They will cut the body also if they are not properly handled. So when I am moving first, then they let the holy grass cut my body first, not your body. You see how respectfully she is praying to Rama to allow her to come to forest. So that's what she was feeling. My husband is everything. Not only thing, he is best of the best ornaments for me. And if you don't have that ornament with me, then even if all other ornaments are there, they're all just waste. They're no use to me at all. That actually, you see, Bharta Nama Param Arya Bhoshanam. Bhoshanadavi. The husband is the Bhoshanam Bhoshanam. He is the ornament more than all the other ornaments. Whereas, if that particular ornament is not there, Yasha Turahita Tena, if I don't have, any lady is not having that ornament, even if all other ornaments are there, she will not be having that grace. That way, it's not just a Sita Devi. Several Pativratas, they are called. They are absolutely perfect translation for the word Pativrata. And because that is a concept, they lived. Anasuya, Sati Savitri, Sati Sukanya, thousands of ladies, they sacrificed their entire time just for the happiness of their husbands. It's the most important shloka that reflects our entire culture of our Bharatiya system, Bharatiya Sanata Sampradaya. Most important shloka that we should inculcate in all our children, sir. Thank you, sir.
Chant the whole shloka one time and then we'll go to the next one, next topic. Bharta nama param naryah bhushanam bhushanadapi esha turahita tena bhushanarhana shobhate.
Bharta nama param narya bhushanam bhushanadapi esha turahita tena bhushanarhana shobhate. Bharta nama param narya bhushanam bhushanadapi esha turahita tena bhushanarhana shobhate.
Thank you, sir. Now,
so now we'll go to the next.
Yeah, next item. Dr. Murthy Garu, if you are available, please log in, sir. If you are already log in, come out. Venkat Garu, please allow him if he is available.
Yeah, he's already in, I think. Yeah, Murthy Garu is already in. So he is also the co-host. I'm going to make him the co-host. Okay, so you should be able to share also. I have his sharing. So let me first. So are we going to the shlokam, sir?
No, he's shlokam chapmantara. Okay, let me complete.
Yeah, then we'll come to the other ones.
Okay, one prayer shloka is there. I will be telling. Please say. Then immediately afterwards, Murtiyar will follow. Andy? So today's shloka is on one of our greatest sages of this country, that is Sage Vyadavyasa. If you are, actually our literature today is totally so rich, our culture is so rich, and everybody is indebted to one great sage, particularly that is Sage Vyadavyasa. If you are touching Bhagavad Gita or if you are touching other parts of Mahabharata, First of all, we should make a shloka with respect to him. That shloka, let us get by heart today. Vyasam Vasishtha Naptaram.
Vyasam Vasishtha Naptaram.
Shakte Pautramakalmasham.
Shakte Pautramakalmasham. Shakte Pautramakalmasham.
Parasharatmajam Vande.
Parasharatmajam Vande. Parasharatmajam Vande.
Sukatatam tapo nidhim.
Sukatatam tapo nidhim. Sukatatam tapo nidhim.
Once more we'll have. Vyasam Vasishtha Naptaram.
Vyasam Vasishtha Naptaram.
Tell me.
Okay. Vyasam Vasishtha Naptaram.
Shakte Pautramakalmasham.
Shakte Pautramakalmasham. Shakte Pautramakalmasham.
Parasharatmajam Vande.
Parasharatmajam Vande. Parasharatmajam Vande.
Shukatatam tapo nidhim.
Shukatatam tapo nidhim. Shukatatam tapo
nidhim. Here you see the entire family history of that great sage. Who is that great Vyadavyasa? His great grandfather, grandfather, his father. Everybody is great. They are all great sages. He is Vyasa. First of all, we started with the name of Vyasa himself. He is Vasishtha Naptaram. That is his great grandson of Vasishtha Maharshi. Vasishtha, you know, such a great sage who guided Sri Rama, who trained Rama, Sri Rama. And for several generations, he is the great person. So, Vyasa is born in the family of Vasishtha, great grandson. Great grandson is called as Napta. He is a great grandson of Vasishtha. Then, Shakte Pautram. Then, who is his grandfather? His great grandfather is Vasishtha. Then, who is grandfather? Vyadavyasa's grandfather is Shakti. Shakti is another sage. He was killed in a younger age itself. He did not live for a longer time, but he became a very famous sage in his short duration also. Shakti Pautram Akalmasham. He had never committed any sin. No bad remark. Who is that? That is Vyasa. Then who is the father then? Parasharatmajam. Vyadavyasa is the son of directly sage Parashara. That is, we have, if, so far, you know, Vasishtha. Vasishtha's son is Shakti. Shakti's son is Parashara. Now Parashara's son is Vyadavyasa. Then one more generation, they carried that great legacy. Shukatatam tapo. And he is the father of, Vedavyasa is the father of great sage Shoka. Shoka is the summary of our entire Indianhood. If at all you want to see entire Indian concept in one personality, that is Shoka. Such a great person. Suppose you want to see the summary of entire all the Vedas, all Vedangas, all Upanishads, everything put together in a human form you want to see, that great person is undoubtedly, without hesitation, we can say, is a great sage Shoka. Now this sage Vyadavyasa is father of that person. So here, how many generations are given, you see? Vasishtha. Then first, that is second is Shakti. Third one is Parashara. Then fourth one is Vyasa. Then fifth generation is Shoka. Five generations are described in this shloka. And what type of person ultimately? There are two words. Akalmasha and Taponithi. Taponithi, he is the embodiment of penance. That is a great shloka. You should get back. All the most of the people who got by heart Bhagavad Gita, they must have got it. Others also who have not got it, they should get by heart. That's why this shloka is selected for this week. Thank you, sir. Now you can ask more clearly, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. So let me. Murthy Garu, so you can unmute yourself. You are already unmuted. I'm going to share the screen, the presentation.
Yes.
Is this the right one, sir?
Yes. today's topic is another great scientist of India, that is Homi J. Bhabha. Now our Murthigari, Dr. Murthigari will describe his greatness. Welcome Murthigaru. Welcome Murthigaru from America to India.
అప్పుడప్పుడు తెలుగులో చెప్పరా వీళ్ళకి పిల్లలుగా ఉన్నారంతా
అంటే కొంతమంది ఉన్నారు ఒకళ్ళిద్దరు వాళ్ళు తెలుగు రాదు పర్వాలేదు చెప్పచ్చు తక్కువ కొంచెం ఒక 10% పర్వాలేదు కానీ
ఒక బాయ్స్ అండ్ గర్ల్స్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ టు యు ఆల్ యు ఆల్ పార్టిసిపేటింగ్ టు లెర్న్ మోర్ అబౌట్ ద సైన్స్ అండ్ అవర్ హిందూ కల్చర్ నౌ లాస్ట్ టూ presentations I made on Sir C. Raman and Jagdish Bose from America when I was in America. Now I came to Hyderabad and now I am talking to you today another great scientist, Homi Jahangir Bhabha. How many of you know about Bhabha? I don't think. Because Bhabha is a great person, a scientist, an Indian nuclear physicist. Nuclear means atomic. He has worked on atomic and the architect of nuclear science in the country. And he's the father of Indian nuclear program. And he's also the founder director for many institutions like prestigious institutes in India, that is TFIR, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, and Trombay Atomic Research, Trombay Atomic Energy Institute. Next please. Next please. His early life, if it is, he is born in 1909 at Bombay. His parents, Jahangir Parmushi Bhabha, well-known lawyer, and mother, Meheran Bhabha. And Bhabha never married, he's a bachelor. And he, in the up to 15 years age, early age, he went to the school in Bombay and the cathedral and Elephant Stone Colleges. Dorab Tata, in India you know Tatas. Dorab Tata is Baba's uncle. He wanted to become a good engineer and mechanical engineer and wanted to send him to Cambridge. So accordingly he went to the Cambridge and obtained a very good degree in mechanical engineering with honors in 1932. And he studied theoretical physics also later and got doctorate in the theoretical physics, nuclear physics in 1934 at the age of 23 years from Cambridge. His professor was Paul Dawn. Next please. And when after completing his, he has started writing papers, absorption of cosmic radiation in 1933 itself. And because of his paper, Isaac Newton Fellowship was granted to him in 1934, a very prestigious fellowship to him in Cambridge. He also worked with great scientists like Neil Bohr and calculated to determine the cross-section of electron positrons, electrons, how they behave, electron, proton, and neutrons, etc. And worked with another scientist like Walter Herit in 36 and developed the cascade theory of electrons. And he returned to India and joined in one of the greatest institutes, IISc, Indian Institute of Sciences, Bangalore, a prestigious institute in our country, India. And he also established a cosmic ray research institute in that campus. Next question. He is also later, he is a theoretical physics and a chief architect of Indian Atomic Energy Program. He was, Bhabha was given the nuclear and founder director of the TFIR. He has appointed the chairman of the Atomic Energy Commission of India. That is one of the commission for doing work on research and other activities of atomic energy. And the facilities. And one of the foremost scientists, and his instrument. What Bhabha's and he is the instrument in making the scientific programs of the country in the atomic energy, and started Bhabha Atomic Research Center, very prestigious department of the government of India, the commission. And Bhabha is also elected as the Royal Society of London, UK, very prestigious award. Next, please. And what he discovered? Homi Bhabha helped in own motherland. He requested G.R.D. Tata at that point of time to support him for research. Bhabha also requested the Prime Minister of India at that point of time, Jawaharlal Nehruji, he wanted to go to the Canada, and Prime Minister has approved to go to Canada and work with the Canadian theoretical physics and work on the nuclear energy and reactors work. And he wanted to make the atomic reactors, and the second step was to teach other countries also how the nuclear energy and nuclear reactors to be developed for their each country. Next, please. So this is one of the picture where he is discussing with another country, other countries, scientists, how the reactors is to be assembled and how to be made. Next, please. My success will not depend on what A and B thinks, and it is my success will be the make of my work. That is his theory and his dialogue. Next. Homi Bhabha and peace. You see, nuclear means it is to be used only for the peace and should not be any calamities. He wanted to use the nuclear only for the energy power sector, that is the power generation sector, by making their nuclear reactors. Bhabha led the first UN conference held in the peaceful uses of atomic energy in Geneva. In Geneva, in 1955, his vision to limitless power of industries through nuclear fusion promoted by nuclear energy control and prohibition of atomic bombs. He is not interested in bombing worldwide. He advised the government for making nuclear reactors using the thorium and uranium. That was the ingredients for the nuclear energy. And how to use these reserves that we have in our country for the nuclear power stations in India. Next. And he rejected the cabinet post also in the government when offered, and served as a scientific advisor to the Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, as well as Lal Bahadur Shastri at that point of time. Bhabha got many awards and rewards from Indian and foreign universities. He was the fellow of the American National Academy of Sciences, again a prestigious position, and awarded the Padma Bhushan in 1954. In quantum physics, the cross-section of electron positioning and scattering was named Bhabha scattering in his honor. Next. What his vision is, the world knew that the power of atomic energy is, and since he has been thinking using the energy for peaceful purposes. As India stood for his own feet and convinced the Prime Minister and for the setting up of an energy atomic energy commission, and the Prime Minister accepted that, and there was a great opposition at that point of them with the politicians and the parliament, that we cannot spend money on this only for food and shelter and other things, we have to take care of the people. The Prime Minister, Bhabha convinced the Prime Minister to set up the Atomic Commission, and he succeeded. And Bhabha could further visualize the utility of atomic research and development in the country and abroad. Bhabha's name is associated with scattering with the involved relative exchange scattering of the electrons and Bhabha-Helton theory wise. So that is the electron positioning in showers the cosmic rays in the atomic reactors. So at the age of 31 itself, he has made all these efforts, and he is also associated with eminent physicists like Paul, Dirac, Cockcroft, all the scientists and Nobel laureates in other countries. And Baba is the founding director of the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research at the Trombay Atomic Research Establishment. And it is named after him. After that, it's the Baba Rich Atomic Research Center. The first reactant was operated in Bombay in 1956. And Baba led the first UN conference that they held at Geneva on the atomic energy. Next, please. He promoted the nuclear control prohibition of bombs and was against manufacturing the atom bombs in the country. And he had enough resources to do so, even though we have enough resources. Instead, he suggested the production of atomic reactors should be used to lessen India's misery and poverty. These reactors for the power generation, electricity, you all know, without electricity, we cannot live even one single second. So, these atomic reactors are used for the power generation purpose. Baba made the scientific advisor to the Prime Minister on this issue. And he called him J.R.D. Tata, appreciated his work. And he always used to call him as a scientist, engineer, a master builder, an administrator. And he's also very good to humanities with the love of art and music. Next, please. Baba visualized the Department of Atomic Energy as an umbrella for the scientific and technological developments of India. So he wanted to make another institute in the country, that is Council of Scientific Industrial Research. So on that model, the Baba Atomic Research Center also to be established over the And Department of Atomic Energy has many wings, has been formed, and it has many wings across India. In the institutes are called Indira Gandhi Center of Atomic Research at Kalpakkam. Industrial units like power generation units, Nuclear Power Corporation Department, and allied institutes, TF, or again Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai. Saha Institute of Nuclear Physics, Calcutta, Tata Memorial at Bombay, Institute of Physics at Bhubaneswar, Nuclear Fuel Complex and Heavy Water Plants and whatnot. Many across the country, from Kanyakumari to Kashmir, we have many departments, many plants are working for research as well as power generation, electrical power generation. Next, please. Next. After returning, Baba, as I already told, he is joined in the Bangalore, realizing the merger of research facilities available there. He communicated to willingness to J.R.D. Tata, but he has not continued to work at IIS Bangalore. And he started working with J.R.D. Tata and asked him to help for the research. And Tata Trust and government, Mumbai and central government, effort, they could have put a good institute, a very prestigious institute in the country in Bombay, that is Tata Institute of Fundamental Research in 1945. Yes. Next, please. Well, when making the production of atomic reactors, people used to work 24/7 all the days and without sleep. And he wanted to encourage the people, the staff who are working.
Murthyar, slightly voice konja loud ga unte baaguntundi koncham daggiriga
ashish
daggiriga speaker daggiriga.
And he wanted to give help the people who are working by providing transport to their house, because they are working day and night. And when he asked the government has rejected Again, he asked the Prime Minister to help, and Prime Minister agreed to provide transport to the people, the scientists and workers working the assembly. And now that is followed in all parts with his effort. Next. And talent search. And Tata Institute of Fundamental Research and DAE, that is Department of Atomic Energy, needs many scientists. He cannot alone, but he wanted more scientists for the new challenges. Homi Bhabha continued to spot creative people all over the world, invited them to India, and gave all the facilities possible for research and development. Again, as the traditional method of setting up a department and recruiting a person for it is followed the method of identifying a person and building the group around him or her. So, Bhabha often said, let the group of innovative people come together and start work, and building come later. That is his proverb. And he used to say, make the search for the people across the next place. He liked to interact with the people with all walks of life across the globe, in the world. He has good contacts, not God granted, good contacts with all main scientists working in foreign universities. Many of them gladly agreed to visit India and become honorary fellows of the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, and invited many people. Next, please. Next. So, these are the scientists in the picture. There is a scientist is discussing with the foreign scientist, inviting to India. Next, please. And taking our affairs personally, he is very much interested to create facilities for the people who are working in the Department of Atomic Energy, and by giving healthcare to the people and are the members of the staff who are working in various sites across the country. And he is also wanted to give good education to the employees' children with the central syllabus. And he has talked to the Minister of Education and set up very good central schools in each industry where they are working, and staff people, children need not go elsewhere, and they got very good schooling in their particular factories. Next, please. This is where Bhabha is showing to the Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, the reactor and how it is functioning in one of the nuclear reactor, the Trombe in Bombay. Next, please. He is a natural lover, Bhabha. Anyone, children, you may not visited, but your father's parents must have visited some of the units in atomic energy in India. The culture of maintaining closeness to the nature has come with the later Homi Bhabha. He himself was a nature lover and ensured that the working place should be pleasant, enhancing creativity among the researchers. So many of these factories and industries will have beautiful gardens as to the make good pleasantness and happiness while they are working in the working places. And he is a music lover and painter. Bhabha loved music and paintings. In spite of his busy schedule, he used to spare some of these hobbies like this, and he used to squeeze some time to music and painting. And in TFIR, you can see many of his pictures, paintings, and in the Trombe and Kolaba. And Bhabha, some of his paintings you can see at the Bhabha, were drawn by himself itself. Next, please. You see, what is this nuclear energy? Just to tell you some of the, what is nuclear energy? We have power generation, electrical power, you know? Electrical power is generated by many fuels like coal, that is gogu, coal, oil, gas, wind, solar, all these aspects are there. And mostly we are using oil and coal. But nuclear energy is the cleanest energy. There is not be any pollution. And that is how this nuclear energy, nuclear power reactors are done. But the nuclear energy in France, if you see, out of 100 megawatts, if you produce 78% nuclear there in the France, they are using, and Belgium 34%, Korea 39%, Switzerland 37%, Japan 30%, USA 19%, Russia 16%, Africa 4%, China 2%, India only just 2%. Now they wanted to, because many problems are there, because our requirement of 1.3 billion people, the factories, houses, the nuclear energy, if we produce, it will be cleaner and more power we can generate. And government of India is thinking to enhance up to 25% nuclear energy by 2050. This is just as to scenario I wanted to tell you what is the nuclear power. So this is one of the Baba Prime Minister opening at the BARC in 1961, Baba Atomic Research. Finally, it is unfortunate that in 24 January 66, he died in a plane crash, aeroplane crash that took place in foreign soil. It is a great loss to the country. He is still remembered at the institution he had set up, an atomic energy establishment, Bombay, and named after him as BRC. A section devoted to conducting research in science and mathematics education was also established in 1970. Was named after him. He is known as the Homi Baba Center for Science and Education. Next, please. Next. So, his birth centenary was celebrated in 2009. And let us salute the great son of Mother India on the and which was celebrated in the birth centenary 2009. And his innovations and his research and guidance to the government of India by setting his exemplary scientist. And we all must appreciate. And the children, boys and girls, this type of scientists, we must take it as a models. And innovative thinking is to be created among you so that these scientists, how they have come up with this. They are also like your boys. You also can make such innovations of the great scientists like what we discussing, like Baba and many other scientists. I will introduce some more scientists in the next weeks. And best of luck. All my best wishes to the children. Thank you.
Thank you, Mutiyar. Thank you. Nice of you. Actually, today's lecture, it reflects the devotion with which some scientists born in this country, they worked for the development of this country. They have plenty of opportunities if they want to earn money. But still, they came back. They struggled hard. It's not so easy. It's not a cakewalk here. They have to struggle. They struggled and built up an India, which is now actually this generation is enjoying. Because the electronics, last week we have seen Dr. A.S. Rao, he's the right-hand man of Dr. Baba. Dr. A.S. Rao, yeah. Actually we had his details given about 2 weeks back, actually. So wonderful, sir. Thank you, Moti. Thank you. Very nice. Very nice presentation. Nice of you. Next.
Welcome, sir. Bala Bhaskar garu.
Because Nadia, the shloka. Ma, shloka only. Ready, sir?
Yes, it's in the shogun ready.
Okay, sir. Now again, coming back to Vedic mathematics. Yeah. Now you see, just oksari paatra chadiyadam sir okka sari gaba gaba meeru display pettara okka sari varasaga aa ikkada chinnam shatam akkada inji tirulu chupistara meeru edo consistent ga chupisthe dani padu తెలుగు పెట్టండి.
ఓకే,
తెలుగు వచ్చేటప్పుడు అది శతం శత. ఇప్పుడు చూడండి, నో లెట్ అస్ సీ. ఎస్ సార్,
సారీ
అంత అక్కర్లేదు. ఇది ఇది ఉంచండి, ఈ సెకండ్ మిడిల్ది బాగుంది.
ఇచ్చారా?
ఇది సరిపోతుందండి. దీని తర్వాత రైట్ సైడ్ పెట్టాలి మాకు. నౌ లెట్ అస్ సీ, వి హావ్ బీన్ లెర్నింగ్ ద ఇండియన్ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ యాజ్ రికార్డెడ్ ఇన్ రామాయణ, నాట్ ఇన్ ఎనీ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ బుక్ బట్ ఇన్ ది స్టోరీ బుక్ రిలేటెడ్ టు శ్రీరామ అండ్ సీతాదేవి. వీ గట్ ప్లెంటీ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆన్ వేదిక్ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్. ద నెంబర్ సిస్టమ్స్ ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దిస్ యాక్చువల్ వీ స్టార్టెడ్ లెర్నింగ్ లాస్ట్ వీక్. వీ హావ్ గాన్ అప్ టు సంథింగ్ నౌ లెట్ అస్ జస్ట్ రికాపిట్యులేట్. ఐ విల్ బి రీడింగ్ అవుట్ శతం శత సహస్రాణాం కోటి మాహుర్మనీషిణః శతం కోటి సహస్రాణాం శంకురిత్యభిధీయతే. వి స్టార్టెడ్ విత్ థౌజండ్స్ యాక్చువల్లీ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ అండ్ 1 lakh, దట్ ఈస్ 100 lakhs ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1 crore, దట్ ఈస్ బిగినింగ్ పాయింట్. నౌ 1 lakh crores, 1 lakh crores ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ శంకుహు, దట్ యాక్చువల్ దిస్ ఈస్ గివెన్. సో ప్లీజ్ రిమెంబర్ శంకు స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ 10, కోటి ఆర్ కోటి మీన్స్ ఆర్ క్రోర్, క్రోర్ స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ 10^7, వేర్ ఆర్ శంకు స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ 10^12. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ లెట్ అస్ సీ, శతం శంకు సహస్రాణం మహాశంకురితి స్మృత. సో మహాశంకు ఇది 1 lakh శంకుస్ ఇది కాదు మహాశంకు. సో ది పవర్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ బై 5 ఫర్దర్. సో నౌ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 10^17. మహాశంకు మీన్స్ 10^17, దట్ ఈస్ 1 forward ఈస్ 17 zeros. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ మహాశంకు సహస్రాణం శతం వృందమిహోచ్యతే. నౌ 1 lakh మహాశంకుస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ వృంద. సో ది పవర్ నౌ అగైన్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ అనదర్ బై 10^5 times. సో ఫ్రమ్ నౌ వృంద స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ 10^22. నెక్స్ట్ సార్ ఇక్కడ ఉంది, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ అలా ఉంచండి. శతం వృంద సహస్రాణం మహావృందమితి స్మృత. సో 1 lakh వృందాస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ మహావృంద. మహావృంద మీన్స్ 1 lakh times, మీన్స్ అగైన్ యాజ్ ఇన్ ది ప్రీవియస్ కేస్ ద పవర్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ బై అనదర్ 10 1 lakh times. సో ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 10^27, దట్ ఈస్ 1 followed బై 27 zeros. నెక్స్ట్ ఇమీడియట్లీ ది సేమ్ శ్లోక హీ గివ్స్ నెక్స్ట్ నెంబర్ ఆల్సో, మహావృంద సహస్రాణం శతం పద్మమిహోచ్యతే. నౌ 1 lakh మహావృందాస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ పద్మ. సో ది వాల్యూ ఈస్ 10^27 × 10^5, దట్ ఈస్ 10^32, దట్ ఈస్ పద్మ. 1 followed బై 32 జీరోస్. దెన్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ శతం పద్మ, ఐ థింక్ దిస్ ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ కవర్డ్, శతం పద్మ సహస్రాణం మహాపద్మమితి స్మృతం. సో మహా 1 lakh పద్మాస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ మహాపద్మ, దట్ ఈస్ 10^32 బికమ్స్ 10^37 నో మహా ఫర్ మహాపద్మ. నెక్స్ట్ మహాపద్మ సహస్రాణం శతం ఖర్వమిహోచ్యతే. నౌ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ 1 lakh మహాపర్వాస్, మహాపద్మాస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఖర్వ. సో ది పవర్ అగైన్ ఫర్దర్ ఇంక్రీజెస్, it becomes 10^42. This also we have seen. Now next one, shatam, it
should be kharva,
shatam mahakharva, kharva cheppamandi, shatam padma kada, shatam kharva sahas, ikkada spelling padi tappu padindi wrong padindi, shatam kharva sahasranam mahakharva miti smrutam. So mahakharva is further 1 lakh times the kharva. That is, you have to increase the power by another 10^5. It becomes 10^47. Now, I think last week, we told up to this point. Mahakharva. Please remember. Now, next shloka I will read out. Mahakharva. Next line. Mahakharva. Mahakharva sahasranam samudram abhidhiyate. That is, 1 lakh mahakharvas is called as samudra. Samudra is not ordinary ocean. It is not filled up with water. It is filled up with numbers now. Samudra is a word indicating 1 followed by 52 zeros. This is important. Now let us read out this shloka again once more. Shatam kharva sah pai shloka. Shatam kharva padma gadu. That is actually, please replace that word. शतम खर्व सहस्राणाम महाखर्व मिति स्मृतम शतम खर्व यस सर शतम खर्व सहस प्लीज रीड आउट योर सेल्फ आई विल बी रीडिंग मूर्ति वेंकट गारु मीरु चेप्पंडि शतम खर्व सहस्राणाम
शतम
हाँ चेप्पंडि एवरेवरु
शतम खर्व सहस्राणाम
महाखर्व मिति स्मृतम
महाखर्व मिति स्मृतम महाखर्व मिति स्मृतम
महाखर्व सहस्राणाम
महाखर्व सहस्राणाम महाखर्व सहस्राणाम
समुद्रम अभिविद्यते अभिधीयते समुद्रम अभिधीयते దాని తర్వాత శ్లోకం కూడా చెప్పేస్తానండి నెక్స్ట్కి వెళ్ళిపోదాం మనం శతం సముద్ర సాహస్రం అలా చెప్పండి శతం సముద్ర సాహస్రం
శతమోఘసహస్రాణాం
మహౌఘ ఇతి నిశృతః
ఓఘ ఇది విశృతః మహౌఘ ఇది విశృతః
నౌ యు సీ ద పవర్స్ దే ఆర్ ఇండికేటెడ్ సముద్ర వి హావ్ సీన్ యాజ్ ఎ టెంపర్ ఆఫ్ 52 దెన్ 1 లక్ సముద్రస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఓఘ ఓఘ ఇట్స్ వాల్యూ విల్ బి 10 పవర్ ఆఫ్ 57 1 ఫాలోడ్ 57 జీరోస్ ది అనిమాజినబుల్ నంబర్స్ నౌ 1 lakh oghas. What is the word given to us? Mahaugha. Please spell out correctly. Mahaugha. Not mahogha.
Mahaugha.
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 This is the last number given by Valmiki. Sage Valmiki. Its value will be 10 to the power of 62. 10 to the power of 62 means 1 followed by how many zeros?
62
zero. Now, last time I told you, I will ask you to explain in terms of crores. How many crores this 10 to the power of 62 means? How do you tell me? Now you tell. Who will answer? I told you the method. That 62 you divide by 7. How many times it will go? 8 7
are 56.
8 7
are 56. Any sir, quote London.
ఏమండి
ఎన్నిసార్లు కోట్లు కోట్లు ఉంటుంది అడుగుతున్నా
అదే చెప్పండి
హౌ
మెనీ టైమ్స్ యు రిపీటెడ్ దట్ కోట్ల నౌ యు టెల్ ఐ ప్లీజ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద ప్రాసెస్ 62 డివైడెడ్ బై 7 Fully, how many times? 8 sevens are 56. 9 sevens are 63. But I wanted only 62. So 8 is the number for 8 times 10 to the power of 7. But the remainder is there. That is 10 to the power of 6. 56 plus 6 is 62. So 10 to the power of 6 into 10 to the power of 6 is 1 followed by 6 zeros. That is 10 lakhs or 1 million. So 10 to the power of 6 means 10 lakhs, then you have to say crores 10 times, 8 times.
Dasalaksha kotla 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 kotla
kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla
kotla
kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla kotla Very, very important numbers. Mahoga is very biggest number. Alright? Not, it is not, somebody is putting, is it about 8.85 crores? No, it's wrong. Pranav, it's not 8.85 crores. It is crores of crores. Like that you have to say 8 times. Preceded by 10 lakhs times. 885 crores, 885. But we are having several crores of crores of crores. That is the biggest number. Okay. Very interesting. So with this, actually, next time I will ask you all the words which we learned in this 6 or 7 slokas, starting from 100, then 1,000, then lakh, then crore, then followed by 1 lakh crores, what we call. Then what is that next one? What is the next one? What is the next one? Ultimately, up to Mahoga, you have to tell me. I will get by, I will ask you. And one important thing is, next week we'll have one great person coming to bless you. That is Brahmasri Samavedam Shanmukha Sarmagaru. He promised to come to our session. He will be blessing you all. So please get prepared. And if we get time, definitely I will ask you this question. All these words you should get by heart. Okay? Now we'll give to Bhaskar.
Also, for next week's class, you can invite all your friends and families.
Yes, you invite all your friends. Though they are not coming regularly, you can invite everybody. Let us have maximum number of people participating. Bhaskar, you can take your own time. No problem. No time limit for you. Don't think that we are cutting short your time. We children are very much interested to listen to you. More important. Thank you.
Hi, Sujan, the Prashna, Aditi.
Thank you, Guru. Hi, Sujan, you have raised a hand. Please continue.
Please note down. Okay, I am taking 5 minutes more. No problem. I am going to tell all the important words. You note down either in English or Telugu or Hindi, whatever you want, you can note down. Most important. All the shlokas you may not remember, but the words you should remember. And the values also. You write down vertically. Vertically write down the words. On the right hand side, values also, I will tell you. Okay, I am starting. The first one is Koti. Koti. Bhaskar garu, meeru 10^7 kinda chupinchandi. Veelavutunnamo. 10^7 power. Nee word cheptuntanu. So its value is 10^7. Now you will be seeing on the screen that also. Okay, sorry. Let me prepare this. 10^7. Yes. That way you can write down. Next. Again, let me go back to Venkatgar screen. Get both on me. Akan to be the end. Bhaskar garu. And you're going to 10^5 times. Pencil to end. Me screen me prepare this one. Display the other. Venkatgar me to pencil on the screen. Next one is Shanku. The words I will dictate. Shanku. Next one. Mahashanku. Mahashanku. Then next one. Vrunda. Vrunda. V-R-I-N-D-A. Vrunda. Next word is Mahavrunda. M-A-H-A-V-R-I-N-D-A. Mahavrunda. Akala. Five. Next one, Padma. Padma. P-A-D-M-A. Next one is Mahapadma. Mahapadma. Next one is Karva. K-H-A-R-V-A. Karva. Karva. Then next one is Mahakarva. Mahakarva. Then next one, Samudra. S-A-M-U-D-R-A. Mahasamudra led. Andhapaka padam led. Mahasamudra led. Samudra. Next is Ogha. O-G-H-A. O-G-H-A. Ogha. Ogha. Then next one is Mahaugha. Au, normally they are written in two ways. Some people, AU is taken as au, or OU also people will be writing. AU is correct. AU is au. Mahaugha. M-A-H-A-U-G-H-A. M-A-H-A-U-G-H-A. Now you see, immediately Bhaskaraya has given the entire table. Koti, actually, it is first line is 10 to the power of 7. We should say 10 to the power of 7. To the power of. Please remember, already some children are not familiar with this terminology. Please start learning it. It is power of. Koti is 10 to the power of 7. Then Shanku, not Shankha Kadan, Shanku. Shanku, S-A-N-K-U. S-A-N-K-U. It is 10 to the power of 12. Mahashanku. It's a 10 to the power of 17. Go on increasing the right side numbers. That is a 10 to the power of 7. Next one is a 10 to the power of 12. That is 7 to 12 is 5. Again, add 5 to 12. You will get 17. Again, add 5 to 17. You will get a 22. That 22 is Varanda. Urundam kadu urunda yamakkaledu. Alaga pain kuda. Urunda. Maha urunda is 10 to the power of 27. Then Padma is 10 to the power of 32. Then Maha Padma is 10 to the power of 37. Then Karva is 10 to the power of 42. Then Mahakarva is 10 to the power of 47. Then Samudra is 10 to the power of 52. Then Ogha is 10 to the power of 57. Then Mahaugha is 10 to the power of 62. 62. Adi, please remember. Okay. Your name ka rasgon vardi, rasiskon gamun rasiskondi. Koti. ఎన్ని వర్డ్స్ వచ్చాయి జస్ట్ లెటర్ కౌంట్ కోటి శంకు మహాశంకు వృంద మహావృంద పద్మ మహాపద్మ ఖర్వ మహాఖర్వ సముద్ర ఓఘ మహౌఘ 12 వర్డ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ దీస్ 12 యూ షుడ్ రిమెంబర్ ఇన్ ది సేమ్ ఆర్డర్ విత్ దేర్ వాల్యూస్ ఓకే నైస్ థ్యాంక్ యూ భాస్కర్ గారు
Okay. If you want to note it in Telugu.
Adi Shanku anustani Shanku gal Shanku. Shanku gal. Shanku.
Ka.
Mamutledu. Kakhalo. Utledu daniki. Okay. మొదటి లెటర్ రావాలి కు ఉందా లేదు పర్వాలేదు వాటర్ హైస్ట్ వాటర్ అది ఇది కరెక్ట్ అదే కాపీ చేయండి నెక్స్ట్ కూడా అంతే సరిపోయింది ఉందా మహా ఉందా పద్మ మహాపద్మ ఖర్వ మహాఖర్వ సముద్ర ఓఘ మహౌఘ ఎక్సలెంట్ అండి ఎక్సలెంట్ వెరీ నైస్ భాస్కర్ గారు లవ్స్ తెలుగు దట్ ఇస్ ఏ యాడెడ్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఫర్ అస్ ఈ లవ్స్ తెలుగు Very nice. Yes, sir. Can you send all the shlokas in the group? Yes, definitely we'll send. Venkata Garu?
Yes.
They are asking for the shlokas to be sent in the group. Can you send me the list? You send me it and I will put it in the group.
Okay, sir. I'll send
or you it. Also can put it, sir. If you are, I think you are, otherwise, definitely. Otherwise,
yes. Yeah, I can send it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I have all the shlokas. I can include even the Narayana Namaskutra and Namaskriti.
Yeah, please send me a copy also, sir.
I'll send this file to you.
Sir. What are covered and what are not covered, I can just have a vision at a glance.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Sir. Yeah. Yes, sir. Next.
Yeah. Good morning and good evening, kids. In last two sessions, we covered Nikilam. Once again, I am just giving a glance of last two sessions. After that, we will be continuing with the new case, case 3. Nikilam means, the meaning of the word Nikilam is complement. When to use this mantra or sutra is to multiply two numbers if at least one number is closer to the base number. Here I used a terminal word base number. I hope you are aware of what is base number. That means all the 10 powers. Now covered Koti, Maha, Koti, Shanku, Mahashanku, all those are also base numbers. Okay. So powers of tens. That means 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, 10 lakhs, 1 crore. 1 crore is Koti, 10 to the power of 7. From there you started in this chain. Koti, first one. So these are the base numbers. First case we discussed is both numbers are more than base number. That means 102 into 103. Just ping me the answer. 102 into 103. Aruna Aditya, excellent. Mayuk, Rishit, Danyasri, Sankalp, Anish. Very good. What about the remaining people? Kameshwari, good. Palguni, good. Krishna, super. Pranav, super. Aditi, super. Sai Srujan, very good. Okay. Akhilesh, very good. Agastya, very good. Pranami, very good. Akhilesh, very good. Naga, very good. Yeah. Daksha, very good. Yeah. So, both numbers are more than base number. Then, the complements are positive and you did it. Then both numbers are less than base number. You do this sum. Example, 998 into 996. Please do the sum and ping me the answer. Very good. Kameshwari, very good. Gavan, very good. Sankalp, very good. Sai Srujan, very good. Mayuk Susarla, very good. Dhanvi Sri, very good. Varuna Aditya, Agastya, Aditi, Naga, Kiran Kumar, Rishit, Akhilesh, yeah, Pranavi. So, why I am reading your name is everyone must participate in this. Then only you will gain the knowledge. If you are not responding, that means you didn't understand the concept. So, please participate in this calculation activity. Okay, Krishna, very good. Siri, Krisha, very good. Yeah. Very good. Thank you. And one more sum. All of you please do. 97 into 95. 97 into 95. Sankalp, very good. Those who are very attentive, they will respond very quickly. Even though we are not seeing face to face, we can catch your state of mind. Okay, very good, very nice. Krishna, Aditi, Pranavi. Very nice. Next. Next sum in the same pattern. 9998 into 9997. Yeah, Sankalp, Gavant, Rishit, Srisha, Aditi, very good. Aditi, I think you did a mistake. Please correct, one more zero has to come. Karan Kumar, very good. Last class we discussed the case 2, Pranav. Okay. Pranadi, very good, Sankal. Yeah, that's fine. Now, coming to the case 3, one number is, first case is both the numbers are greater than this number. Second case is both the numbers are less than base number. And the third case is one number is greater than base number and one number is less than base number. In that scenario, how you will do? That means there is a scenario like 98 into 103. 98 into 103. Okay. You see now, 103 is giving positive complement and 98 is giving negative complement, like minus 2. Because it is less than base number, it is giving minus 2. You add in any diagonally, crosswise, 103 plus minus 2 or 98 plus 3. That means in any direction you add diagonally, crosswise, if you add 103 plus minus 2 or 98 plus 3, that is 101. 103 plus minus 2 into 100 plus 3 into minus 2. If anybody don't know negative number, what is minus 2, just multiply those two numbers and put minus in front of that number. That's enough. 103 plus minus 2, 101 into 100 minus 6. 3 into 2 is 6. Since it is minus 2, put minus symbol. That means 101 00 minus 6 equals to 100 100 94 100 94. Okay. If you are feeling difficulty with this number, just 98 plus 3 also you can do. Instead of 103 plus minus 2, you can do this crosswise also. 98 plus 3 into 100 plus 3 into minus 2. 3 into minus 2. Hi, Srujan. I think you have doubt. Please ask.
అక్కడ చిన్న అక్కడ ఉన్న నంబర్ 101
I mean 10,100 kani minus 6 6 chestey okay yeah sorry nenu ekkada okachi confuse ayyanu
okay no problem okay so ila aina cheyochu ledante meeru 98 plus 3 ala aina cheyochu meeru ela chesina same answer vastundi 98 plus 3 into 100 plus 3 into minus 2 that means 101 into 100 minus 6 10100 minus 6 ఇలా చేసినా మీకు అదే ఆన్సర్ వస్తుంది ఆన్సర్ షుడ్ బి సేమ్ ఓకే ఇన్ ఎనీ డయాగ్నల్ యు టేక్ ఇట్ షుడ్ గివ్ 101 ఓన్లీ ఇన్ దిస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఓకే హియర్ ఇన్ బోత్ ఇన్ ద ప్రీవియస్ కేసెస్ కేస్ 1 అండ్ కేస్ 2 ఇఫ్ బోత్ నంబర్స్ ఆర్ అబోవ్ బేస్ నంబర్ ఆర్ బోత్ నంబర్స్ ఆర్ బిలో బేస్ నంబర్ వి యాడెడ్ బట్ యు నీడ్ టు బి కేర్ఫుల్ in this scenario that if one number is above base number and one number is below base number definitely you are doing subtraction only here you are doing subtraction of multiplication of complements there you should be more careful okay now you do very small start with very small and let us go to a bigger number so that you can understand the process very well you just do 7 into 12 I know most of you know the answer but do with the Nikilam method do with the Nikilam method what is the base number in this scenario please ping me the base number yeah Krishna very good yeah good do it using Nikilam method of multiplication and tell me the answer so always start with the small and go to the very big one then you can understand the process very easy naga wrong answer do it carefully yes Yes, 84 is the correct answer. I am doing, just observe. 7, that means minus 3 is the complement. And 12, positive complement, it will give 2. You add in any direction. 12 plus minus 3 is 9. 7 plus 2 is 9. 7 plus 2. Into base number is 10 plus minus 3 into 2 9 into 10 minus 6 that means 90 minus 6 equal to 84 okay Sai Srijan now you got the concept Your voice is not audible.
Do you hear me? Guru gari ippudu vinipistunda?
Ah, vinipistundi sir. దూరంగా మాట్లాడుతున్నాం చేయండి సరే ఇప్పుడు నేను 12 ప్లస్ మైనస్ 3 చూపిస్తాను చూడు 12 ప్లస్ మైనస్ 3 into 10 plus minus 3 into 2. 12 plus minus 3 and 12 minus 3. 12 minus 3 is, I am putting that extra step.
9.
మీకు నెగటివ్ నంబర్స్ అవ్వకపోతే మీరేం ఫీల్ అవ్వకండి, జస్ట్ యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యూచర్. వన్స్ ద వన్స్ యూ గెట్ ద నెగటివ్ నంబర్స్ కాన్సెప్ట్ యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్. 9 × 10 మైనస్ 6, దట్ మీన్స్ 90 మైనస్ 6 ఈక్వల్ టు 84.
అర్థమైంది గురు గారు, థ్యాంక్ యూ.
అదితి, యు రైజ్డ్ ఎ హ్యాండ్, ఎనీ డౌట్?
నో.
ఓకే.
బిఫోర్ ఐ హాడ్ ఎ డౌట్ బట్ నౌ ఐ డోంట్.
ఓకే. నౌ when you are doing with the small numbers, you are understanding where you are facing the difficulty. Okay, just do it. 18 × 14 please do using Nikila method of multiplication only. Rishit, we can use Nikila Navataha Charaman Dastaha ka for subtraction, but when you are doing with base numbers only, I have clearly mentioned when to use Nikila Navataha Charaman Dastaha. Here you are doing subtraction with normal numbers, not with base numbers, so in this case don't use that concept. If you have to use, there are some conditions to be followed. Rishikesh, just check your answer once again. Yeah. Good. 8 is minus 2 and 14 is 4 plus 4. That means 8 plus 4, 12. 14 plus minus 2 is 12. In any direction, it is 12 only. So I am doing 8 plus 4 first, and then base number is 10, and then 8 plus 4, 12. 12 into 10 minus 8. That means 120 minus 8 equal to 112. This is, I have taken 8 plus 4. Just now you check with 14 plus minus 2 also I am doing. 14 plus minus 2 into 10 plus minus 2 into 4. 14 plus minus 2 equal to 14 minus 2. Well, into 10 minus 8 equal to 120 minus 8 equal to 112. Okay. This is the answer for 18 × 14. Okay. Understood? I am going to give a little bit tough sum. Now, with the base 100, I am giving 96 × 107. Please do this. Okay. That is the answer. 10 10 272. Yeah. Palguni is asking to show me the definition. Just I am going to the first page. If anybody didn't noted the meaning and when to use, please note it. I will be there on that page for 3 minutes. Yeah, Palguni, please note. If you are already noted in the last session, no need to note it again. Just for the benefit of Palguni, I have kept this page. He requested to go for this mantra page, then I kept. Yeah, now let us go to our sums. Once again, one more sum. Let us do with the 1000 base, and then after that, let us take homework for this case 3, and then we can go for prayer. 998 into 1003. please do. What is the base number in this case? Yeah, Krishna, very good. Gavan, Pranav, very good, very good. Sweetruti, very good. Yeah, now you do. Please ping me the final answer.
భాస్కర్ గారు ఇంకా చూడండి క్లోజ్ చేయండి.
Yeah, now 9 8. Okay, this is the answer. That is the whatever I have shown is the correct answer. If you are having the same answer, that is correct. Otherwise, you did a mistake somewhere. Okay. So that's all for today. Case 3. With this, we completed all the 3 cases of Nikilam method of multiplication. Okay? Nikilam method of multiplication. Please note down the exercise sums. Right. For this case, you just note down. Yeah, please note down. If you want, I am pinging in the chat box. You can copy and save it in the. But please complete. Okay, that's all for today. Sorry. Thank you, Rishit.
Nice.
For correction.
I pinned.
Okay, I pinged in chat box also. If anybody missed it, you can please copy from the chat box and save it in your notepads. Thank you all.
You can see it in the chat box.
Completed, Guru.
Okay, thank you. So, children, we have a wonderful day today. Excellent shlokas, good presentation. Patel, one of our greatest scientists of this country, who made foundations for advanced technologies in very early times, immediately or just during the beginning of our independent India. Finally, we have concluded with good examples, set of good examples from basic mathematics. Now we'll have our Kaya Navacha. Now, ओम कायेन वाचा मनसेन्द्रियैर्वा बुद्ध्यात्मना प्रवृत्तेस्वभावात् करोमि यज्जत् सकलं परस्मै नारायणायेति समर्पयामि हरि ओम तत्सत् महात्मस्तु
गुरु गारु नाकु ओक प्रश्न उंदि
आ अडिगमा
मीरु चेप्पारु कदा सीत सुंदरकांडलो టైం ని మనం ఏమి మార్చలేము మనకి ఎంత కష్టాలు ఉన్నా మనము అవి కష్టాలు పోకపోతే అవి మన అది పూర్వజన్మలో ఏదైనా పాపాలు చేస్తే అవి అన్నారు కదా
అవునమ్మా
అప్పుడు సీతాదేవి పూర్వజన్మలో ఏమి చేయలేదు కదా లక్ష్మీదేవి కింద అప్పుడు సీతాదేవి ఎందుకు వచ్చింది బాధలు
పూర్వజన్మలో చేసిందమ్మా కొంచెం పూర్వజన్మలు చేసింది అందుకోసం వచ్చింది ఎలాగంటే ఆ స్టోరీ అడిగేదని చెప్తాను అంటే భార్యాభర్తలు ఇద్దరు ఎవరు చేసినా కానీ ఇద్దరు షేర్ చేసుకోవాలి విష్ణుమూర్తి చేశాడు దాని మూలన సీతాదేవి కూడా ప్రాబ్లం వచ్చింది ఏమైందంటే ఒకసారి తెలుగులో చెప్పినా ఇంగ్లీష్లో చెప్పిన మరి ఓకే ఒకసారి రాక్షసులు అంతా కూడా దేవతల మీద యుద్ధానికి వచ్చారు ఆ యుద్ధంలో దేవతలు ఓడిపోయారు ముందర వాళ్ళంతా ఏం చేశారంటే శ్రీ మహావిష్ణువు దగ్గరికి పరిగెట్టుకుంటూ వెళ్ళారు దేవతలు అయ్యా మమ్మల్ని రక్షించి ఆయన విష్ణుమూర్తి రంగంలో ప్రవేశించాడు రాక్షసుల దగ్గర వచ్చి మీరు వెనక్కి వెళ్ళిపోండి నా దగ్గర చాలా పెద్ద పెద్ద ఆయుధాలు ఉన్నాయి శంఖం చక్రం ఇలాంటివన్నీ ఉన్నాయి నేను తలుచుకున్నానంటే మళ్ళీ గట్టిగా కొట్టేస్తానని చెప్పి వార్నింగ్ ఇచ్చాడు వాళ్ళు వినలేదు ఇంకా విష్ణుమూర్తికినో రాక్షసుకి యుద్ధం స్టార్ట్ అయింది ఇంకా విష్ణుమూర్తి కొట్టే దెబ్బలకి వాళ్ళు ఇంకా అప్పటికి అర్థమైంది ఆయన బలం ఎంతో ఇంకా వాళ్ళు పరిగెట్టుకుంటూ వెళ్ళిపోతున్నారు ఈయన ఏమన్నాడు ముందర వార్నింగ్ ఇచ్చాడు కదా మీరు ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళినా సరే మిమ్మల్ని చంపేస్తాను జాగ్రత్త అన్నాడు అందులో నాయకుడు ఉన్నాడు వాడిని డెఫినెట్ ముందరే వార్నింగ్ ఇచ్చాడు నాతో యుద్ధం పెట్టుకుంటే వాడిని చంపుతానన్నాడు వాడు కావాలని పెట్టుకున్నాడు కానీ విష్ణుమూర్తితో వాడు ఫైట్ చేయలేకపోయాడు వాడు కొంతసేపు ఇంకా పారిపోవడం ప్రారంభించాడు వాడు పారిపోతుంటే విష్ణుమూర్తి వదిలిపెడతాడా ఆయన చేసింగ్ స్టార్ట్ చేశాడు వాడిని వాడిని వెనక వెళుతుండగా వాడు ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళిపోయాడు వాడు వాళ్ళ ఊరు వెళ్ళిపోయి వాళ్ళ గురువుగారి ఆశ్రమంలో దూరేసి కూర్చున్నాడు రాక్షసులు గురువుగారు ఎవరు శుక్రాచార్యుడు ఆ శుక్రాచార్యుడు ఆవిడ ఊళ్ళో లేరు ఆయన గురుగారు భార్య ఉన్నారు ఆవిడతో చెప్పా నన్ను విష్ణుమూర్తి చంపడానికి వస్తున్నాడమ్మా కాస్త రక్షించండి అన్నాడు సరే అని చెప్పి వాడిని లోపల పెట్టేసేసి ఆవిడ గుమ్మంది అడ్డంగా నుంచుంది అడ్డంగా నుంచుంటే ఇంతట్లో విష్ణుమూర్తి వచ్చాడు అమ్మ ఫలాన వాడు ఇక్కడ ఉన్నాడు రాక్షసుడు వాడిని వదిలిపెట్టేసేయి వాడిని చంపాలి వేడ అన్నాడు చంపాలంటే ఆవిడ కుదరదు నేను వాడి శరణి ఇచ్చాను నువ్వు తప్పుకో అమ్మా వేడని చాలా నిజంగా చేసి తీరుతాను నువ్వు తప్పుకోను మళ్ళీ ఆవిడకి వారిని ఇచ్చాడు నేను తప్పుకోను చేతనైతే నన్ను చంపేక వాడిని చంపుకోమండి ఆవిడ ఆ పరంగా విష్ణుమూర్తి ఏం చేశాడు వెంటనే చక్రం ప్రయోగించాడు ఆవిడ ముందర ఆవిడని ఖండించేశాడు కానీ చేసి రాక్షసుని కొట్టేశాడు. అయిపోయిన తర్వాత కొంతసేపటి శుక్రాచార్యుడు మళ్ళీ ఆశ్రమానికి వచ్చాడు. ఆయన వచ్చేవాడు మొట్టమొదటి గేట్లో ఏం కనిపించింది, ఆయన వైఫ్ బాడీ కనిపించింది. బాడీ కనిపి ఆ పడగా ఆయన కోపం వచ్చింది. కోపం వచ్చి ఆయన ఏం చేశాడంటే, ఎవరైతే ఈ పని చేశారో అంటే తన భార్యను ఎవరైతే చంపారో వాళ్ళకి భార్యావియోగం కలుగ్గాక అని చెప్పించేశాడు ఆయన. అది ఎవరికి ఇప్పుడు ఎవరికి జరగాల భార్యావియోగం? విష్ణుమూర్తికి. అందుచేత ఒక అవతారంలో ఎప్పుడో ఇలాంటి పని పెట్టుకున్నాడు ఆయన. లిస్ట్ అన్నమాట, ఆయన భూమికి వస్తే ఎప్పుడప్పుడు బజార్లోకి వెళ్ళేవాడు ఏమేమి ఐటమ్స్ కావాలో కొనుక్కొని లిస్ట్ రాసుకున్నట్టుగా ఆయన వైకుంఠం నుంచి భూమి వచ్చేవాడికి పాత చేయవలసిన కమిట్మెంట్స్ ఏమున్నాయి అని లిస్ట్ రాసుకుని వాటన్నిటి ప్రకారం ప్లాన్ చేసుకుంటాడు ఆయన. అందుచేత రామావతారంలో ఇక్కడ భార్యావియోగం జరిగింది. అది కదా, అర్థమైందా? అదే నెక్స్ట్ ఇంకా ఏమన్నా
మొన్న అంబేద్కర్ జయంతికి ఆ రోజు నేను టేబుల్స్
మాట నాకు క్లియర్గా వినిపించలేదమ్మా, ఎవరు మాట్లాడారు?
అంబేద్కర్ జయంతి కదా.
ఏది ఏది?
అంబేద్కర్ జయంతి 14వ తారీఖున.
అంబేద్కర్, ఓకే. అయితే
ఆ రోజు నేను ఏం చేశానంటే, ఆయన చాలా తెలివైన వారు, మొత్తం చాలా మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ కూడా తెలుసు ఆయనకి అని. నేను కూడా మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ లో నేను కొంచెం వీక్ అందుకని ఆ రోజు మా మదర్ ఒక ఆయన లక్ష్యం పెట్టాను అనమాట. ఆ రోజు మొత్తం ఇక్కడ 30 నుంచి 20 వరకు మొత్తం టేబుల్స్ ఒక్క రోజులో చదివేసి అప్పచెప్పాను.
అబ్బో వండర్ఫుల్, క్లాప్స్, వెరీ నైస్, వెరీ నైస్.
సాయంత్రం వరకు దాంతో నానా తంతాలు పడ్డాను.
ఇప్పుడు మన వేదిక మ్యాసలే ఇంకా కంఠస్థం చేసి ఇక్కడ వేసేయచ్చు, టకటకటకటే వేసుకుని వెళ్ళిపోవచ్చు టేబుల్స్. అది నెక్స్ట్ నెక్స్ట్ చెప్పారా? ఇంకా చెప్పలేదు. చెప్పమ్మా శ్రీకృతి.
నాకు నేను మీకు శబ్దం మీరు కథ చెప్తుంటే ఉంటే ఇంకొకలాగా కూడా విన్నాను ఒక చోట. అక్కడ ఒకసారి పార్వతీదేవి రావణాసురుడు శివుడు ఆత్మలింగాన్ని తీసుకోవడానికి వెళ్తాడు, తపస్సు చేస్తాడు. అప్పుడు ఆత్మలింగాన్ని తీసుకుంటే అప్పుడు శివుడు ఉండడు కదా, రావణాసురుడు అక్కడ ఉంటాడు. అందుకే అందుకే విష్ణుమూర్తి మాయతో శివుడు మనస్సుని ఇది పార్వతీదేవి దగ్గర, రావణాసుడు మనస్సుని పార్వతీదేవి దగ్గర పెడతాడు. అప్పుడు పార్వతీదేవిని తీసుకెళ్ నాకు పార్వతీదేవి కావాలి అంటాడు. అప్పుడు పార్వతీదేవి అప్పుడు తెలుస్తుంది పార్వతీదేవికి. అప్పుడు పార్వతీదేవి శాపిస్తుంది నీ భార్యను కూడా రావణాసుడు తీసుకెళ్ళిపోతాడు అని.
ఇలాగా రకరకాల కథలు ఉంటాయి. ఏ పురాణాలు మరి బోల్డ్ అని ఉన్నాయి, అందులో అవి మనం మనం రాయలేదు. ఈ మధ్య ఎవరు రాసిన వాళ్ళు ఇప్పుడు లేరు. ఏమయ్యా ఆ పుస్తకంలో అలా ఉంది, ఈ పుస్తకంలో ఇలా ఉంది, ఏది రైట్ ఏది రాంగ్ అని మనం అడుగుదామంటే తెలియట్లేదు నాకు. కానీ అది చదువుకోవడం సరదా కథగా తీసుకున్నాం. కానీ అసలు పరమాత్మ యొక్క తత్వం తెలుసుకోవాలంటే గాడ్ అంటే ఏమిటి చదవాలంటే భాగవతం చదవాలమ్మా. భాగవతం అత్యద్భుతం, అది నిజంగా అల్టిమేట్ ఎసెన్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ సనాతన ధర్మం అనమాట. ఇంకా తర్వాత ఇంకా చదవడానికి ఏం లేదు, ఇంక పుస్తకాలు ఏం లేవు. ప్రస్థానత్రయం, తర్వాత నెక్స్ట్ ఏమిటంటే లాస్ట్, అది లాస్ట్, ఇంకా ఫైనల్ మెర్జ్ అయిపోవడం, వాటర్లో సాల్ట్ వేసి ఎలా డిజాల్వ్ అయిపోతుందో అలా భాగవతం చదువుకుంటూ అందులో లేనైపోవాలి. అప్పుడు ఈ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఇంకేం రావు. కానీ దాని ముందర మాత్రం ఈ ప్రిపరేషన్ అంతా చేసుకోవాలి. ఓకే, ఆల్ ది బెస్ట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ, థ్యాంక్ యూ అమ్మా. ఉందామండి మరి, అయితే ఇంకేమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయా ఎవరికైనా? ఇంకా వెరీ నైస్ సార్, కలుద్దాం మడి. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్, నమస్కారం. వెంకట్ గారు అందరూ కూడా గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి, నెక్స్ట్ వీక్ మన ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఎక్కువ చూసుకోండి. ఓకే, సామవేదం షణ్ముఖ సార్
గారు.
అమ్మా
గురుగారు,
ధన్యవాదాలు. అందరికి ఆశీర్వచనం అమ్మా, అందరికి
ఆశీర్వచనం. నాకు ఒక ప్రశ్న ఉంది,
అడిగమ్మా.
ఇప్పుడు కృష్ణుడికి తెలిసింది కదా తను విష్ణుమూర్తి, కృష్ణుడికి తెలిసింది కదా తను విష్ణుమూర్తి అవతారం అని. మరి రాముడికి దేవతలు చెప్తే గానీ ఎందుకు తెలియలేదు?
ఆయన కావాలి అలా. ఇప్పుడు వీళ్ళంతా అవతారం వచ్చిన వాళ్ళు సరదాగా మాట అంటాను, ఇంకో రకంగా అనుకోకు. వీళ్ళంతా డిఫరెంట్ సినిమాల్లో ఒకే యాక్టర్ రకరకాలుగా వేస్తాడు. ఎందుకు? ఆ స్క్రిప్ట్ రాసినాడు అలా రాసాడు కనుక, ఆ నాటకం రాసినాడు ఎవరైతే ఇలా ఇలా యాక్ట్ చేయాలన్నాడు, ఇంకో డైరెక్టర్ ఏం చేశాడు ఇలా యాక్ట్ చేయమన్నాడు. అలాగే డిఫరెంట్ అవతారాలు వచ్చినట్టు రకరకాలుగా చేస్తాడు ఆయన. అన్నింటిలోనూ ఒకే రకంగా చేస్తే ఎలాగా? ఓ రకంగా ఏమో, ఒక సపోజ్ ఎన్టీ రామారావు అన్నారు గొప్ప పెద్ద హీరో, ఓ దాంట్లో ఏమో ఎలాగ శ్రీకృష్ణుడా ఉంటాడు, ఇంకో పక్కనేమో దుర్యోధనుడా వేస్తాడు. ఏంటి ఇంత మంచి పాత్ర వేసిన ఆయన చెడ్డ పాత్ర వేయడం ఏమిటి? ఓ పక్కనేమో శ్రీరాముడు పాత్ర వేస్తాడు, ఓ పక్కనేమో రావణాసుడు వేషం వేస్తాడు. ఇంత మంచివాడు ఇలాంటి యాక్షన్ ఇలాంటి చేస్తాడు ఏమిటి? అదంతే వాడు యాక్షన్ వాళ్ళు తీసుకుంటూ ఉంటారు. ఓ దాంట్లో మంచి ఆకారం బాగున్న వాళ్ళే చేశాడు, ఇంకో దాంట్లో కుంటి చేత్తోడు వేశాడు, కుంటి కాలు కుంటి చెయ్యి. అది ఆ సినిమా ఆ కథ అలా ఉంది కనుక అలాగా, ఈ కథ ఇలా ఉంది కనుక ఇలాగే అలాగే. ఏం చేసినా అది సినిమాని గుర్తెట్టుకోండి. అసలు ఆయన వేరు, ఆయనకి ఏం ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఏం లేవు. అలాగే అన్నమాట.
ఇంకా నాకు ఒక ప్రశ్న ఉంది.
నీ ప్రశ్న సమాన్
చెప్పారు.
నాకు చాలా క్లాసులు ఉన్నాయి కదా, మరి నాకు కూడా ఇంతట్లో ఫోన్లు వస్తున్నాయి చూసారు కదా, టైం అయిపోయింది.
మీరు కూడా పడుకోవాలి కదండి, తొమ్మిది అయిపోతుంది.
మాకు ఇంకా సంధ్యావనం చేసుకోవాలమ్మా ఇప్పుడు నేను.
అయ్యో
వాళ్ళకి ఇంకా సగం రోజు ఉంది, ఇంకా వారికి ఇంకా హాఫ్ డే టైం ఉంది.
ఇంకో చెప్పాలి, మా ఇంట్లో సూర్యాస్తమయం 9:30 అవుతుందమ్మా. సూర్యాస్తమయం మా ఇంట్లో
అంటే ఇంకా హాఫ్ డే టైం ఉంది అప్పటి నుంచి. ఇంకా
జపాన్ టైమ్ లో ఉన్నారండి మీరైతే.
గురువు
గారు, ఈ వరల్డ్ లో ఏ దేశం ఇప్పుడు ఒక దేశంలోనా ఈవినింగ్ అవుతుంది కదా, అంటే మీరు ఈవినింగ్ చేసుకున్నట్టే
చేస్తున్నాడు. అలాగే అనుకుంటూ ఉంటాను నేను, అక్కడ ఉన్నాను అనుకుని సంధ్యావనం చేస్తుంటాను. ఓకే ఉంటాను మరి, ధన్యవాదాలు అందరికి, అందరికి ఆశీర్వాదాలు.